on this guy. Way back in the late 50s or maybe early 50s, my academic great-grandfather, Willie Feller, proved the not completely trivial fact in those days, but today my computer can do it in 1 second, that this permutation, this statistics, if you normalize it, is asymptotically normal. So in the limit, it also looks like a bell curve. If you make n very, very big, to 1,000, and you look at the expectation, but the expectation is easy. The total number of inversions is n choose 2. And by symmetry, the average, the expected number of inversions is half of that. Because if you have a permutation, with it, and you take it the reverse, you have the total number of options is n choose 2. The total number of pairs, I before j, is n choose 2. So if you have a permutation, and you reverse it, they add up to have n choose 2. So you can pair them up in pairs. And so obviously the average is this, the expectation. So if you take the number of inversions, and it's a little bit harder, it's some cubic to find the standard deviation. I forgot what it is. And you look at this, normalized random variable, in the limit, it's the Gaussian. You get a bell curve. This was proved by Willie Feller. It's in his famous book, in probability theory. And thanks to McMahon, we know that the major index is also, because the same probability distribution. So we know that the major index and the number of inversions, both these permutation statistics are so-called asymptotically normal. Asymptotically normal, if you have a sequence of discrete probability distributions, and you do the obvious thing, subtract from the average, from the expectation, divide by the standard deviation, and you take the limit and go to infinity, then the probability density function will be the famous Gaussian. E to the minus x squared over 2 over square root of 2 pi. So we knew that separately the major index and the number of inversions are asymptotically normal. But what about the interaction? The first thing you want to ask about the interaction was to find the correlation. So reminding you, the correlation between two random variables is the expectation of the product. So in this case, we have ins, and we know the average, and over. So we take the average of this. So we can define a brand new random variable, not permutation. Take a permutation, find how many inversions it has, subtract the average, find how much off it is, away from the average. Now for the very same permutation, compute the major index and do this and sum it up over all permutations and divide by n factorial. You get so it's some expression. And one of the greatest probabilities alive today, Svante Jansson, about 15 years ago, asked one of the greatest computer scientists alive today, Donald Knuth, about the so-called asymptotic correlation of ins and mass. Let's call it, I don't know, C of n. So the limit. Sorry, this is a, yeah, this is a, yeah, right, asymptotic correlation. Hansen. And Don Knuth did not have any clue. So he wrote me email and asked me, can you do the asymptotic covariance? Let's say covariance, sorry, not correlation. Let's covariance. A correlation you have divided by sigma and by sigma n squared by the variance. Never mind, let's say covariance. The asymptotic covariance that implies the asymptotic collision, by the way. I didn't know either. So I asked my beloved servant, Shalosh Bi'echad. Shalosh Bi'echad computed it empirically. For n equals 1, n equals 2, n equals 3, n equals 4, and n equals 0, it's labeled the empty permutation. 5 data points. And guessed an explicit expression for this. This is not the asymptotics. It's a closed form formula that Svante Jansson, member of the Swedish Academy of Sciences, did not know. And Dan Knuth, the great guru of computer science, could not do. Shalosh did. The same method I told you before, by generalizing for finitely many cases. And you can justify it by general nonsense, that a priori is a polynomial of at most degree 4. And surprisingly, it happened to be of degree 2. So this was the first step. And what we did with Andrew Baxter was a far-reaching generalization. So in particular, it follows that asymptotically, they're uncorrelated. If you divide by the product, by the variance, the variance is a cubic thing. So it goes to zero. So the corollary, what Shalosh proved 15 years ago, is that the major index and the number of inversions, these two major, no pun intended, permutation statistics, are asymptotically uncorrelated. But you can have lots and lots of random variables that are asymptotically uncorrelated, but nevertheless not independent. So the next natural question was to prove that this mass and inf are asymptotically independent. And now it's more complicated. This is no longer a closed form. So we take the bivariate generating function P inf by Q mass pi. Call it f of n. And try to find an effective way for the computer to compute it. The Shalosh way is completely hopeless. 4 factorial is not too bad. But if you do it for higher order polynomials, 10 factorial is already bad, and 50 factorial is hopeless. So this brute force approach is completely hopeless. But the clever brute approach is fine. So never mind about the details. You introduce generating functions, you introduce recurrences, you get other recurrences, then the computer guesses explicit expressions for the mixed moment this time. That a posteriori, the computer can automatically prove the implied recurrences. So it's guessing polynomials. And once the computer has guessed these polynomials, proving the recurrences are obviously correct, because it would not have been possible to guess it if it weren't. But even a posteriori, just trying this conjecture recurrences is a completely routine exercise. And the stupid referee replied that we skip steps. It's just plugging in. That's all it takes. So the novelty here maybe in some sense is trivial. It's saying that the emperor is naked. It's really, really, in a way, trivial. But I think it's a major breakthrough in that you can use empirical guessing method to make it fully rigorous. And I hope, Mr. Referee, that you're going to watch this video and change your mind. If you do, please send me an email, and I forgive you for all your sins. Thank you very much.